Hello everyone, welcome to Pharma Elite and welcome to our new series that is making pharmacognosy easy. आज हम ये वीडियो में बायोलॉजिकल सोर्स के बारे में पढ़ने वाले हैं. दैट इज विल बी सॉल्विंग सम एमसीक्यूज जो बायोलॉजिकल सोर्स से आते हैं. कॉग्निसी में हमेशा ऐसे कुछ ना कुछ क्वेश्चंस आपके पेपर में आएंगे जो बायोलॉजिकल सोर्स, सिनोनिम्स या केमिकल टेस्ट से रिलेटेड होते हैं. एंड वी ऑफन फाइंड कॉग्निसी बीइंग डिफिकल्ट टू रिमेंबर और वी टेंड टू फॉरगेट थिंग्स. सो लेट्स मेक इट इजियर विद आवर वीडियोस. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज Shellac is a resinous substance which is prepared from the secretion that encrusts the bodies of a scale insect. मतलब क्वेश्चन ये है कि शेलैक जो रेजिनियस मटेरियल है वो किसी इंसेक्ट के सिक्रीशन से बनता है. सो विच इज दैट? कैरियालाका, विवेरा सिवेट, एसिपेंसर हुसो एंड एल्वेरेटस मोशिफेरस. What are all these options? First, we need to know which of this is an insect. Now, Vivera civet is a variety of a cat. Essipenser huso is a variety of fish. And Alvarites moschiferus is a variety of deer. Sorry, there is a typo error over here. It is D-double-E-R, deer. So, all these beings, the species of catfish, only one which is a species of insects is option A. But still, let's confirm in. This is the insect which gives us shellac, that is the resinous material which we obtain from the scales of insect. So, Kerikalaka, the first option is correct. Next question pe jaate hai. The biological source of ergot. Matlab ergot ka biological source kya hai, ye hume poocha hai. Aise hi direct questions aate hai. So, it is all about memorizing cognosy. Dried leaves of Dubiosa myoporoids, seeds of Colchicium autumn, roots and rhizomes of Cephalus ipecacuanha and fungal sclerotorium of Claviceps purpurea. Ab hame ye pata hai ki ergot, it grows on the rye, that is ovary of rye plant. It develops inside that and it is basically a fungal growth jo rye plant ke ovary mein banta hai. So ergot, it cannot be a leaf, it cannot be a seed or a root rhizome. The only option we are left with which shows a fungal sclerotorium, that is a growth inside ovary, is option D. So the correct answer here is biological source for ergot is fungal sclerotorium of Claviceps purpurea. Next question. Ephedra is obtained from dash of Ephedra sinica. Abhi ye aapko picture dikh raha hai. This is a picture of Ephedra jo aapne cognosy ke lab work mein bhi dekha hoga. Ephedra, it is basically obtained from this plant. This is a picture of it, that is the source from where you get Ephedra. Now, what is it we use it? Whether leaf, root, stem, or seeds. You can clearly make out from this picture that it is the stem part of it which is being used as Ephedra. That is Ephedra from the Ephedra sinica. But what are the other options also hum dekh sakte hai? Leaves of which plants are used as Vasaka, Coca, Dubiosa, tea, and digitalis. Roots of ginseng, gentian, ipecacuanha, equinite, and ashwagandha. Stems of manjistha, quassia, arjuna, and ashoka. And seeds of nux vomica, colchicium, areca nut, coca, and coffee. Abhi yahan hume ephedra ke bare mein pucha hai. You might be asked a question in exam based on seeds. कि ऐसे कौन से प्लांट है जिसके सीड्स यूज होते हैं, जिसके लीफ यूज होता है. सो बेसिकली आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि विच आर द लीफ प्लांट्स, विच आर द सीड वंस एंड रूट एंड स्टेम वंस. इन दिस केस इफेड्रा द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज स्टेम पार्ट. वी कैन सी दिस इज द इफेड्रा विच वी यूज फॉर कॉग्नोसी फार्माकोग्नोस्टिक प्रैक्टिकल्स. Digitalis is obtained from dried leaves of dash. Our next question is digitalis ke source ke bare mein poochta hai. That is, from where do you get digitalis? Now, we all have studied in our semesters that digitalis ke bahut sare source hai. D. lanata, T. purpurea, D. lutea, and there could be even more. So, yaha hame poocha hai ki whether it is A, B, C, or all of the above. In this case, it is digitalis lutea, Digitalis purpurea as well as D. lanata. So the correct answer would be option D. Digitalis ke ye sabhi sources correct hai. You can refer to some standard reference book like Cognosy by Cocate, Rangari. All these books will give you detailed information about biological source. Before we move further, do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Make sure you press the bell icon so that you get a reminder when we post a new video. Also, we are having a free WhatsApp group where we are posting daily MCQs for GPAT, NIPER, other entrance exams, pharma related latest news, job openings. So if you want to get added to a group, just message us on this below mentioned number, which is at the bottom of the screen. We will add you to our group. Which of the following is obtained from birds of Urginia maritima? Apna next question ye hai ki what do you obtain from birds of Urginia maritima? This is the picture of it, Urginia maritima. Ye jo birds hai, isse hume kya milta hai? Indian squill, Chinese squill, European and Japanese squill. These all are different varieties of squill. Now let us see what do we obtain from Urginia maritima. For Indian squill, the source is Urginia indica. You can easily remember Indian indica. And Chinese and Japanese squills, the name itself tells you they are different elite species. So for European squill, the one which we get is from this plant of Urginia maritima. That is, the birds of this plants are used to give us European squill. So the correct answer is option C. See, cognoscency, basically all the questions are memory based. There is no concept as such to explain when it comes to biological sources. Next question is, mention the biological source of G. stropanthin. ये अपना पिक्चर है स्ट्रोपैंथिन, जी स्ट्रोपैंथिन का. व्हाट इज इट्स बायोलॉजिकल सोर्स? स्ट्रोपैंथस कॉम्बे, स्ट्रोपैंथस ग्रेटस, स्ट्रोपैंथस हिस्पिडस एंड स्ट्रोपैंथस सरमेंटस. नाउ स्ट्रोपैंथस कॉम्बे इज आल्सो नोन एज सिंपली स्ट्रोपैंथस और एरो पॉइजन. स्ट्रोपैंथस ग्रेटस इज मेनली आल्सो कॉल्ड एज ओबेन और स्ट्रोपैंथिन जी. दीस आर द अदर नेम्स एंड इट इज द सीड्स ऑफ दिस व्हिच वी आर यूज्ड टू ऑब्टेन स्ट्रोपैंथस. व्हेयर स्ट्रोपैंथस हिस्पिडस इज आल्सो नोन एज स्ट्रोपैंथस. So the correct answer for strophanthin G, that is its biological source, is the seeds of strophanthus gratis, that is open. Next, asparagus racemus is also called as dash. This is the picture of asparagus racemus. What is its other name, you are being asked? Yasti, Sinega, Shatavari, Jalabrahmi. Now we know that yasti is a synonym, yasti, that is for Glycyrrhiza glabra, that is licorice. Sinega is Polygyla sinega, that is its name. For Jalabrahmi, it is Centella asiatica. And Shatavari, its source is Asparagus racemus. Asparagus racemus is also known as, called as Shatavari, that is the roots and leaves of it. So the correct answer here is option C. Next one, dash is obtained from Gelidium amnasi. This is a picture of Gelidium amnasi. What is it now? Whether it's acacia, agar, algin or gaur gum. Ab hum sabko pata hai ki acacia is a gummy exudation which we obtain from Acacia arabica. Agar is different thing. Let's first look at algin. It is a algal species from Macrocytisus pyrifera. Gaur gum, which is obtained from endosperm of seeds, very typical example in cognoscency, endosperm of seeds of which plant gives gaur gum, that is Symphysis tetraglobulus. And agar is the one which is here in this picture, jo apne microbiology mein bhi dekha hoga. Agar is which is obtained from Gelidium amnasi, that is from this plant you get agar. So the correct answer is option B. Next question is biological source of garlic. ये garlic का picture है. Garlic का biological source क्या है? Carum carui, Allium sativum, Acrococcus calamus and Piperlongum. Carum carui, what do you get from it is caraway. Acrococcus calamus gives you acorus and Piperlongum gives you long pepper. And Allium sativum is the source of garlic. So यहाँ हमारा correct answer is option B. Last and the 10th one, which gum is isolated from endosperm? Abhi humne dekha tha in the previous, I guess two questions previously, what is it that you get from endosperm, which gum? Sericulia gum, gaur gum, tragacanthin acacia gum and xanthanan gelan gum. Kaun sa gum hume endosperm se milta hai? Now sericulia gum is also known as gum caraya or Indian gum. Tragacanth is the one which is obtained as an exudate from sericulia. Gaur gum is obtained from endosperm of seeds of Symphysis tetraglobulana. Tragacanth and acacia from exudate of Astralagus gummifer and xanthan and gelan gum from bacterial polysaccharide, that is Xanthomonas campestris. So the only one which is an endosperm of it is option P, that is gaurakam. Baki sabke source alag hai, that is it is gum karaya, it is exudate. This is also an exudate and this is a bacterial polysaccharide. So in this way you can get, expect one or two questions based on biological source for your entrance exam. Thank you everyone for watching the video. Stay tuned, more videos will be coming soon.